We are about to come live. Minimize.
If you change your mind, take a chance on the first in line. Take a chance, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know.
All right, guys.
If you got no place to go when you're feeling down.
Oh, are we live yet? Somebody here? Oh! Did I not rename? Oh my god, did I not rename this chat? Shoot, let me, I think I can change the title live here. Dang it. ADF 1 inch lift kit raffle. Dang. Okay, all changes saved. Let me turn down the tunes a little bit. There, yeah, I got your last two entries, Pat, but I gotta make sure. I'm not looking at chat right now. I'm bringing up the page. So how many... What's up, Pat? Chuck? So, Pat, how many entries do you have total? I don't know. Four, maybe? Five? I can't remember. Let me just double check you. One, two, four. I show four for Pat. Is that correct? It should be. I remember the two you put in late. Can someone confirm that the chat title now says lift kit instead of Morimoto? I think I fixed it. So, this is the Anderson Design and Fabrication 1-inch lift kit raffle. It is in here. Six. Before I draw, we're going to take care of all that. I'm going to confirm all your entries. So don't worry. We'll check it out in a minute. You got your lift kit and you got your Subaru swag. You got a Subaru mug / beaker type of thing. You got coasters that have a tread pattern. Good. And I forget what else. Maybe one or two other things. On that lift kit. All right. Yeah, the video's supposed to show ADF. Okay, first thing I gotta do right now is jump to Pat real quick and look at it. How recently did you put... Oh, no problem. How recently did you put those in, Pat? You can hear me, right? I mean, was it today? I didn't get anything today. But I could have sworn I got all your entries. What am I doing? What am I doing? PayPal. I'm checking right now to confirm how many entries I see Pat having. Oh, today? Dude, I didn't get that email. I know I didn't get any payments today. And you were right. You did. Oh my god. Okay. We're all on hold for about 5 minutes while I figure all this out. Did you send in for 4 entries today? 4 additional entries? No, not 4. Okay. I agree, you should have 6. You put in for 2 on the 14th, 2 days ago. And maybe they only came now, but I show 4 today on the 16th. I think one of them was delayed or something. I think that's what happened. Alright, well, I see with my own eyes. You have 6 entries. If you can, I can talk quicker than I can type. If you want to go to Facebook and check for 2 more numbers, you get the last choice. Pick carefully. I owe you 2 numbers. Let me just make sure on my Facebook also. I didn't get the email, so that's why it's missing. Lucky you caught it, or we would have had some troubles in paradise. Someone would have been coming to see me. Alright. So you have 16, 18, 32, and 36. You get 2 more numbers. I'll wait for you to type them in the chat, and then we'll be ready to continue. Hey, there's that Paul Walker looking guy with the stash. I always call him Paul. What the? Oh, I lost it for a minute. There we go. Lord, did you send a private message? I'm just waiting for Pat's two number choices, if he's still there. Okay, there we go. 8 and 24. Let me edit, make this all legal. This is a binding contract, you realize. 8 and 24. I'm looking at a different browser, but you're still seeing me work. 8, I'm putting you in at, and 24, putting you in at. Done and done. All right, I think we are ready to get back on track. Matt has like 5 or 6, Pat has 5 or 6, a couple other people did a onesie, and they'll probably be the one to win, you know how that works. Justin and Scott, and that's actually it. There's only four people in this contest, actually. That's pretty crazy. All right, let's 7:01. I might as well go ahead with this, because probably everybody that has an entry is sitting here anyway. I don't know if Justin Posada's in here, but I don't know everybody's screen names. Yeah, I haven't seen TWRX videos in a while, dude. It's a long break, dude. Come on, Brohemian. Let's get this thing going. I forget what car you have. Oh, Tacoma? No, you still have the Forester and the STI, don't you? That's how long it's been since I've seen your stuff. Oh man, the picture's wrong too in the chat. God damn it. Wait one sec. I hate this. Let me fix it right. Removing image. Oh, there you are. Just in time, or maybe you've been here, I don't know. Let's see if I got a lift kit picture here. Yes. Edit. Can you see me shrinking this and everything? I wonder if you can see all this mess I'm making. Alright. Now we're good. From who? I need entertainment from someone. Oh, from T-Rex, especially. Alright. We're now going to check the max numbers. We're about to do it. The max number is 36. So we are going to set up, find my random number generator on here. Max number to go to, what'd I say, 36? All right, and we're simply gonna hit a generator button. There's only one winner. If it turns out to be a blank, we draw again until we have a name. Good luck to everybody. Thanks for joining the raffle. And let's go from here. 3, 2, 1. And I'll check my Facebook. We have a no blow. It is a 9. Nobody has a 9. We're going to draw again. We're drawing again, folks. 3, 2, 1. Number one, dude. You know how rare that is? That's unheard of to get a 1. Let me see. Nobody. Nobody got a 1. Now Bundy gets a turn. All right. We are going to draw for the third time. We're trying to get a winner here, folks. All right, 3, 2, 1. Number 4, bringing up the thing. Do we get anybody? 4 is a dud. 4 is a dud. Repeat. Failure. We are going to pick number the fourth choice. Let's see what we get. I'm just leaving this Facebook up now. I'm tired of bringing this browser back and forth. This has to be the winner, guys. Pick number 5. Let's see who got it. Ready? Oh my god. Pick number 5 is a failure. Nobody had number 12. We're drawing again. Pick number 6. Hold on. Alright. My almost mint condition macho. This is going to be it. 6. Pick number 6. Oh yeah! Number 10, it's a dud, it's a dud. Oh my god. Man, next time I'll make this a 1 to 10 entry when I have kind of a meager contest, because this is going to be wasting time here. Alright, I'm just going to 3, 2, 1. Oh, come on. Now everybody wants to get out of here and get going with their lives. 0, 0. 3, 2, 1. And we have a winner! We have a winner! Oh, yeah! 34! One of the people that did by 6 entries, Mr. Matt, if you're on a delay, you did win the contest. I don't know if you were even in here. I can't remember. I don't think you are. Maybe you are. So, Matt is the winner of this. I hated to get everybody's hopes up, but, you know, that's all part of the excitement. That's called gambling. And that's all we got going for tonight. 6 or 7 tries, we got it. Congrats to Matt. I hope he's going to use the lift. I don't care if he uses it, but I hope, you know, I hope someone might put it to use somewhere. That's it. Lift kit done. Just the next raffle is maybe even more meager than this, but it's going to be that combo vacuum tire pressure gauge, I think pump, but I can't remember, from China, and a lot of my old stuff. The last remaining limited edition small fat body t-shirt, Last Human's Garage custom t-shirt, the last one, it's only a size small. And a bunch of all the rest of my Subaru swag, whatever that is. Each item is probably worth 5, and it'll probably be a $5 raffle. I'm going to put as much as I can in there to make it better than this one, because this was pretty, only 4 people entered. That's kind of weak, but hey, it's just for fun anyway, you know. So, unless anybody has any last questions, I don't think they do, because I post almost every freaking day. Been painting my toe hooks all day, adding coats of black. A lot of stuff coming on the way. Just for you 10 guys that are watching, I'm not supposed to say much, but I have a mother load coming from Fat Body for the Forester. You didn't hear it from me. Alright. I think that's it. Oh shoot, everybody's gonna see this when it goes live, goddammit. Coupon code? No. I like could barely even get that thing sponsored, man. He's gonna hate me forever because I told him I'd keep it. At the time, I thought I would. Honestly, things change. I mean, I can't please everybody all the time. I can't please every sponsor. So he's probably not happy with me. No, there's no coupon codes for that guy. It's a real small company, so he doesn't have a lot of room for that. I'm getting rid of little parts because I'm just losing all the insignificant junk that the car doesn't really need. But the oil cooler is for racing and track and autocross. That's what it's for. It is not useful on a daily driver. I don't even plan to ever do that with my car. That's why I took the oil cooler off. Nothing else really. What do you mean little parts? What else did I sell? I can't remember. The oil cooler and the lift's been sitting on my shelf for weeks and months. I've been putting off selling it because I thought the ADF would be pissed, but at this point I just had to get rid of it. I'm not going to use it. I'm never going to buy giant knobby tires for my cars. It's just not going to happen. And there was one other question. Oh, powder coat the hooks. Price mainly, and not worth the trouble and fanciness to powder coat hooks, which are made to take abuse anyway. First hook, if a hook ever goes on it or anything, is going to scratch it all up. I don't want to invest all that money in a powder coat, and that's pretty much it. So I got a lot of coats of black gloss. The key is I have to wait a few days before I even try twisting them on, or I'm going to smear that paint and put like this, and I put clothing marks into the paint. It's so soft. So all I got to do is leave the paint a long, long time to dry, that black spray paint, and then it should be just as hard and good as anything. I also painted my covers. I bought two new covers, the tow hook covers for the bumpers. They're $5 each, super cheap. I cut a better hole for the front, a lot more centered and really perfect. Spray painting that gloss black perfectly also. It's going to be a sweet, sweet framework for that tow hook. And then I'm going to be spray painting the back cover probably too, and also cut a hole in that real perfect. And it's just going to be the black accent hooks, which will pop a little more with that black cover rather than the white cover. No, dude, I'm not dancing today. My kids aren't here. And that's too embarrassing to do live anyway. I can't be myself if it's live. All right. Well, I actually got to go out. I want to change my midpipe in a few minutes. I'm always getting bored with my car. I want it loud for tomorrow. I don't care. Oh, I'll tell you one thing I've been doing. Still 10 people? Dang. I've been doing a lot of slight map alterations. Now, there's one thing I can't talk about, but I've been doing a lot of throttle adjustment. I can talk about that. And let's see. I got a new map for some reason, and the throttle didn't feel as strong as it used to. It wasn't as sensitive, right? So then I asked Ron if he can make me a pure OEM throttle feel, which is super aggressive and super strong. And I ran that for a while. It's kind of hard to drive because you push the pedal like that much and you're like 100%. But it just requires so little movement is kind of why I like it. I'm learning how to baby it. And I've gone back and forth the last few days between the throttle I had for months recently and then this new super sensitive throttle. And I swear the car drives faster with the sensitive throttle. Probably because my foot just never stretches far enough to use all the power. So I've got pulled so hard with this super sensitive throttle that I didn't even know my car could do just keeps pulling and pulling to the top. I didn't have that with a softer throttle. And yeah, it's a foot problem. I understand that, but it's so much easier to drive the car fast. I just really think I'm just so torn because it's so, in slower driving, it's kind of hard to keep it smooth, right? It's just kind of hard to control and bumper to bumper, but it's so good for the power. Enough on that. You already know my throttle conundrums. Of course I run E8. Dude, I wouldn't even keep this car if I didn't have E85 on it. It's E50, technically. Not everybody studies ethanols exclusively. It's just an E50 blend. The car is a dog without ethanol. I can't even drive it for more than a day. It just won't rev. It has a cold. It's stuffed up until you put the ethanol in. Then it just revs with a blip of the throttle, like on the videos you see. Just bam, instant. It doesn't do that unless you have ethanol. It just slowly just comes up at like a normal engine. The ethanol just gives you that pop every time you just hammer the throttle. It's so much, it's response is what I feel. 3 weeks, go get 3 jugs. Then I get like 2 free fill-ups in my own garage. And I mean, I only go fill up jugs in my other gas station around the corner for like a 50-50 mix approximately. But I probably have to do ethanol in every car I own for the rest of my life now. Because I can't do without it. Ethanol is probably what changed the car the most in this entire 3 years. Changed the feel of the car the most. It's just night and day. More than a stock to stage 2, I'd say. The ethanol is more of a feel and power than a stock to stage 2. Yeah, I think it is. It's just so smooth. It completely changes the whole thing. All right, I got to go do my muffler swaps and stuff. I got to go out and get some car work done like I do every night. That's probably about it. What time is it? 7:15. People are starting to drop off. All right, dude, I don't think Matt was in here. The one guy that wasn't in here is the guy that won. So I'll send him some chats. I need his address. Oh, man, you know what? I have a feeling that guy was in Canada, especially with that name. That's a Canadian Frenchy name. But I think I'm just going to go with it this one time. I don't want to reject anybody. There was only 4 people that entered. But Clairoux, I think, is a French name. I think it's a Canada dude. I think I like saw some kind of address like that, and I was going to just bring it up, and I said, screw it. All right, guys, well, I'm going to go because I know we're all starting to get bored here, and I'm just rambling on. Thanks for joining. A lot of stuff coming this week. Oil cooler install, all DIY custom. It's going to be super exciting for me and maybe for you. And some small stuff. I got some Forester Black badging coming, some Forester Black stickers coming. And that's probably it for the Forester for now until I get that little thing that we talked about earlier. I don't even know what it is, so we're going to have a huge surprise within a few days here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time.